ओके वी आर स्टार्टिंग। अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। ओके वी स्टार्टिंग सूरतुल बकरा फामुल कुरान फ्रॉम आयत नंबर 158। लास्ट टाइम वी लेफ्ट ऑन आयत नंबर 157। लेट्स सी टुडे हाउ मच वी कवर इंशाल्लाह। अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। नहमदुहू व नुसल्ली अला रसूलिहिल करीम अम्मा बाद। फाऊज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतानिर रजीम। बिस्मिल्लाहि रहमानिर रहीम। रब्बी इशरह ली सदरी व यस्सिर ली अमरी व हलुल उक़दतम मिन लिसानी यफ़क़हु क़ौली। रब्बी ज़िदना इल्मा। अल्लाहुम्मा फ़क़्किहना फ़िद्दीन। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद वर्ड टू वर्ड ट्रांसलेशन आया नंबर 158। ओके इन्ना इंडीड अस्सफ़ा द माउंट सफ़ा व एंड अल मरवता द माउंट मरवा मीन आर फ्राम अमॉन्ग शाइरिल्लाह। इट्स नॉट शायरी, शाइरिल्लाह सेक्रेट सिम्बल्स ऑफ अल्लाह। फ मन फ सो मन हु एवर हज्जा परफॉर्म हज एनुअल पिलग्रिमेज अलबैता द हाउस अवे तमरा अवे एंड और ए तमरा ही परफॉर्म उमरा माइनर पिलग्रिमेज फला फ सो ला नॉट जुनाहा एनी सिन अलैही इज अपॉन हिम अन दैट य तवफ़ा ही डस तवाफ बीहिमा बी साथिमा ऑफ देम टू व एंड मन हु एवर ततवा ही डिड वॉलेंटरली खैरन any good for then inna indeed allah shakirun one who appreciates alimun one always all knowing। okay let's see inna safa just one second inna safa wal marwata min sha'irillah faman hajjal baita ave tamara अवे तमरा फला जुनाहा अलैही अन यतवफ़ा बिहिमा। वेरीली असफ़ा एंड अल मरवा आर ऑफ द सिम्बल्स ऑफ अल्लाह सो इट इज़ नॉट अ सिन ऑन हिम हु परफॉर्म्स हज और उमरा पिलग्रिमेज ऑफ द हाउस और टू परफॉर्म तवाफ बिटवीन देम। नाउ सी इन असफ़ा वल मरवा, एवरीबडी इज़ नो सफ़ा एंड मरवा आर द टू माउंटेन्स and it is the ritual of Hajj and Umrah. Those who ever go there, they have to start from Safa, walking from Safa till Marwa, and from Marwa to Safa, everybody has to take 7 rounds, right, in Safa and Marwa. And this is a sunnah of Hazrat Hajar alayhi salam, because she ascended and descended the two mountains of Safa and Marwa in search of water for her son Ismail alayhi salam while he was a baby. Okay, so in the Safa wal Marwata, verily a Safa and Marwa, two mountains, min sha'irillah, don't say sha'irillah, sha'irillah, min sha'irillah, are of the symbols of Allah. Okay, faman, so it is also, now let's see what is sha'irillah. Sha'ir is the plural of sha'ira, which comes from shaur. So sha'ir, rituals of the deens. You see 1, 2, 3, 4th word, min sha'irillah, sha'ir, rituals of the deen, that symbolizes the deen. Okay, they are very obvious, they are very great. So on Safa and Marwa, there were two idols, Isaf and Naila, at the pre-Islamic time, who were worshipped in the times of Jahiliyyah. What is Jahiliyyah? Jahiliyyah is the pre-Islamic time. So Sahaba got worried, if we do Sahi of Safa and Marwa, isn't it a symbol of Jahiliyyah practice? So Allah told them that no, it is a symbol of Allah because of the sacrifice and faith and tawakkal of Hazrat Hajar alayhis salam. So Inna Safa wal Marwata min sha'airillahi faman hajjal baita awe tamara. So why did Hazrat Hajra do Sahi of Safa and Marwa? In search of water. Why did Allah delay giving her water? Allah was testing her to give her the reward, and then Zamzam water became her property. When you are tested, Allah gives the reward, and she was tested and she was given the reward, and the Zamzam water became her property. Then we see, why do Muslims do Sahi of Safa and Marwa? Because it was the order of Allah that Muslims do Sahi of Safa and Marwa in the remembrance of the strength, willpower, patience, and faith of Hajra alayhis salam. Why? Why Muslims do Sahi of Safa and Marwa? Inna Safa wal Marwata min sha'air Allah. Faman hajjal baita awe tamara. Allah says, verily a Safa and Marwa are of the symbols of Allah. So it is not a sin on them who performs Hajj or Umrah. Faman hajjal baita, who performs Hajj pilgrimage away tamara or perform tawaf, fala junaha alayhi, fala junaha alayhi an yatawaffa bihima. So it is not a sin on him who performs Hajj or Umrah pilgrimage of the house to perform tawaf between them. So this word revived the feeling of restraint and patience in Muslims, because she was also very strong. She was patient. When there was no water, she climbed Safa and Marwa mountain, and Allah gave the reward, and Zamzam water became the property for her. And see the word Hajj. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 words in the first line, Hajja. Hajj, the root word is Ha, Jim, Jim. Literally means to intend. So you go to perform Hajj with an intention and preparation. You buy the ticket, you prepare, you learn the ayah, hadith and ayahs and rituals, what to do, what not to do, you know. So you go with the intention and preparation. So, and yatawaffa, awe tamara, hajjal baita, hajjis hajj, and awe tamara is umrah, okay? So how umrah literally means to ziyara, to visit. Awe tamara, umrah is ziyara, to visit. So it means to visit the house of Allah with the intention to do Umrah. So, and now see the second line, Waman tatawwa, Waman tatawwa, and whoever does good, Waman tatawwa khairan, and whoever does good voluntarily, fa inna Allah, then verily Allah, Shakirun Alim, is all recognizer, all knower. Allah is all recognizer, all knower. How Allah is Shakir? How Allah is recognizer? He appreciates the good that we do. Whatever good we do, Allah appreciates. This is what Allah says, that Allah is all recognizer, he's a shakirun, and all knower, and he's alim. He knows everything, whatever we do. So what lessons we learn? Don't neglect good deeds. Always do good deeds. Focus on doing little good deeds, as Allah knows even small acts of kindness. Because Allah is shakir, Allah is recognizer, Allah is alim, whatever we do. Allah never wastes the rewards of your patience, like he didn't waste the reward of Hazrat Hajra. She was patient, and she climbed up and down. She had tawakkul, faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and she was tested. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed him the zamzam. Test not necessarily come because Allah is angry with you, but because he wants to purify you and give you the reward. So ask from Allah, have faith, and he will provide you from where you cannot imagine. He provides the risk, the sustenance, the provision from where we cannot imagine. Even the ants get the risk, the birds get the risk. The birds, you know, fly in the morning, empty stomachs, and they come, their stomachs fill. Who give them the risk, sustenance, provisions? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them. Okay, so we do the tafsir now. Verily, As-Safa and Al-Marwa are of the symbols of Allah. So it is not a sin on him to perform Hajj or Umrah, pilgrimage of the house to perform tawaf between them. verily, okay. Imam Ahmad reported that Urwa said that he asked Aisha radiallahu anha, Aisha radiallahu anhu is the wife of Prophet Sassam, about what Allah stated. What does this mean? In the Safa wal Marwa min sha'airillah. By Allah, it is not a sin if someone did not perform tawaf around them. Aisha radiallahu anha said, worst is that which you said. Oh, my nephew, because her nephew asked him, if this is the meaning of it, it should have read, it is not a sin if one did not perform tawaf around them. Rather, the ayah was revealed regarding the Ansar and before Islam used to assume Hilal. What is Hilal? Or Ihram for Hajj. Hilal is also Ihram. In the area of Mashalal for their idol Manar that they used to worship. Those who assume Hilal for Manar used to hesitate to perform Tawaf going between Mounts As-Safa and Al-Marwa. Mm-hmm. So they during the Islamic era asked Allah's messenger about it saying, O messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, during the time of Jahiliyyah, we used to hesitate to perform Tawaf between As-Safa and Marwa. Why? Because they had kept the idols over there and they used to worship the idols. So then Allah revealed, verily As-Safa and Al-Marwa are of the symbols of Allah. So it is not a sin on them who perform Hajj and Umrah of the house to perform the going Tawaf between them because they were hesitant because idols were kept there. But now Allah said, you can perform. Aisha radiallahu anha then said, Allah's messenger has made it the sunnah to perform tawaf between them, As-Safa and Al-Marwa, and thus no one should abandon performing tawaf between them. So we should make tawaf when we do umrah. It is a must. This hadith is reported in the Sahihain. Sahihain means two book of hadith, Sahih Muslim and Sahih Bukhari. Sahihain is the tasniya, is a dual. Okay, in Arabic, you know, wahid, tasniya, and the plural. So sahihain and means when yanun comes, it means tasniya, dual. In another narration, Imam Az-Zuhri reported that Urwa said, later on, I, Urwa, told Abu Bakr bin Abdul Rahman bin Al-Haris bin Hashim of Aisha's statement. Whatever Aisha Adela said, he said the same thing to him. He said, I have not heard of such information. However, I heard learned men saying that all the people except those whom Allah mentioned said, our tawaf between these two hills is a practice of Jahiliyyah. Some other among the Ansar said, we were commanded to perform tawaf of the Kaaba, but not between As-Safa and Al-Marwa. So Allah revealed, in As-Safa wal-Marwa min sha'irillah, verily As-Safa and Marwa are of the symbols of Allah. Because they were hesitant because of the idols were there. And then when Prophet ﷺ conquered Makkah, all the idols were destroyed. And Allah says that, verily As-Safa and Marwa are of the symbols of Allah. So, and there are many symbols of Allah, Muna, Muzdalifa, Khanae Kaaba, and never, you know, laugh on the symbols of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the scarves, on the masajids, on the mosque, never laugh. Abu Bakr bin Abu Rahman then said, it seems that this verse was revealed concerning the two groups. Al-Bukhari collected a similar narrations by Anas radiallahu anhu. Isaf, an idol, was on Safa. What was the name of idol? Isaf. Isaf was on Safa, while Naila, an idol, was on Al-Marwa. And they used to touch or kiss them. After Islam came, they were hesitant about performing tawaf between them. Thereafter, the ayah above was revealed. You know, in concluding all, they were hesitant when Islam also came to perform tawaf at As-Safa and Marwa because of the idols. So Allah revealed this ayah that no, you should perform. Verily, As-Safa and Marwa are the symbols of Allah. So you have to perform tawaf over there. The wisdom behind this legislating sahih between As-Safa and Marwa. Muslim reported, Sahih Muslim is the book of hadith, recorded a long hadith in this sahih from Jabir radiallahu anhu, in which Allah's messenger finished the tawaf around the house and then went back to Rukun pillar, that is the black stone, and kissed it. And then he went out from the door near As-Safa while reciting, Inna As-Safa wal Marwa min sha'airillahi. Verily, As-Safa and Al-Marwa are the symbols of Allah. And everybody knows the hadith. I told you before also that this black stone, Hajar Aswad, Hajre Aswad, Allah will give Hajre Aswad on the day of resurrection two eyes and one lip, and he will be witnessing those who have kissed it, you know. And but nowadays there's a great rush, you know, lot of crowd is there. Being a woman, we don't want that, you know, we may be hit by some man because we observe parda. So to save ourselves from that we avoid in rush hours, we go when there is no rush. So no, doesn't matter. While tawaf also you are unable, and there's a lot of crowd, lot of men are there, so don't kiss Hajar Aswad. Then when you are staying there, just find some time, such time that you can do perform tawaf and you can kiss it. And when you go to the rush time, such some other time and kissed it. The Prophet then said, I start with what Allah has commanded me to start with, meaning start the sa'i, that is fast walking from the Safa. And in another narration of An-Nasa'i, the Prophet said, start with what Allah has started with, that is As-Safa. So we start from the mountain As-Safa, but now the mountains are not there. The pictures were shown to you, and you also see on TV that, you know, they have, you know, the mountains are demolished to facilitate the pilgrimage, and those who are doing tawaf and umrah, and those who are doing hajj. So only the signs, little signs are there of that rock is there, little rock is there. Imam Ahmad reported that habitant bint Abu Tajra said, I saw Allah's messenger performing tawaf. Sister Asma, you have raised your hand. Can you put your hand down? Because it's hiding my words. Sister Asma, if you hear me, you have raised your hand, and you know your raised hand is hiding my words from where I'm reading. So put your hand down. I saw Allah's messenger performing tawaf between As-Safa and Al-Marwa while the people were in front of him and he was behind them walking in sa'i. I saw his garment twisted around his knees because of the fast walking in sa'i, and he was reciting Is'au fa inna Allah kataba alaykum sa'i. Perform sa'i, for Allah has prescribed sa'i on you. It means we have to do sa'i. This hadith was used as a proof for the fact that sa'i is rukun of hajj. There are many arkan of hajj, so sa'i is also a rukun of hajj. So 7 times circumambulance during Kaaba, then praying 2 rakah, you know, wajib tawaf, then drinking zamzam water while, you know, doing umrah, then doing the sa'i of Safa and Marwa. So it's a rukun. It was also said that sa'i is wajib and not a rukun of hajj, and that if one does not perform it by mistake or by intention, he could expiate the shortcoming with dam. So what does dam means? If you have left the wajib or any rukun of hajj, then you have to give dam. And what is dam? One has to slaughter a goat or a sheep. Allah has stated that tawaf between As-Safa and Al-Marwa is among the symbols of Allah, shi'airillah, meaning among the acts that Allah legislated during the Hajj for Prophet Ibrahim alayhislam. Now it is said here that earlier it was mentioned the hadith by Ibn Abbas that the origin of tawaf comes from the tawaf of Hajar. Who is Hajra? Prophet Ibrahim alayhislam's wife, between As-Safa and Al-Marwa, seeking water for her son Ismail, because Ibrahim alayhi salam had left them in Makkah. Ibrahim alayhi salam left Hazrat Hajar and Ismail alayhi salam in Makkah, where there was no habitant for her. It was a barren land. No person was there. Only she alone was with Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. When Hajar feared that her son would die without water, she stood up and begged Allah for his help and kept going back and forth in the blessed area between As-Safa and Al-Marwa. She was humble, fearful, frightened, and meek before Allah. Then Allah answered her prayers, relieved her of her loneliness, ended her dilemma, and made the well of Zamzam bring forth its water for her, which is a tasty or nutritional food and a remedy for the illness. From this, I, you know, remember a riwayah. When they migrated from Makkah to Medina, one of the companion of the Prophet said that there's a hadith, there's a riwayah. The gist of the hadith is, he said, I was very weak and, you know, my health was not good and I had nothing to eat, but I was surviving only on zamzam and the dates. And so the zamzam is the nutritional food and a remedy for the illness also. And I have also experienced whenever I go there and in Mecca, you know, to perform Umrah, Hajj, everybody, those who have been there, or you all have, you know, experienced that, that I don't feel much hungry because of Zamzam and because of dates. What I do, I break my fast in Haram and near Khana Kaaba, I break my fast. I pray the Maghrib, I break my fast with Zamzam and, you know, this dates. And then I try not to go out because it's so crowded. By the time you go out after Maghrib, nowadays it's very crowded. I'm talking about Ramadan, right? Whenever I've been in Ramadan, I don't go out. Only I, you know, keep myself on Zamzam and dates. Till, you know, Maghrib is said, I pray that, I break the fast, then till Isha is said, then till the Taraweeh is done. And, you know, I never feel hungry due to this Zamzam, because it is a nutritious food and it's a remedy for the illness also. With ever intention you drink it, you'll get that. Always drink this for the remedy for the illness also. Therefore, whoever performs Sa'i between Safa and Al Marwa will remember his meekness. Whose meekness? Hazrat Hajra's meekness, his humbleness and in need for Allah to guide his heart, lead his affairs to success and forgive his sins. He should also want Allah to eliminate his shortcomings and errors and to guide him to the straight path. He should ask Allah to keep him firm on this path until he meets death, and to change his situation from that of sin and errors to that of perfection, and being forgiven the same providence which was provided to Hajar al-Islam. So we should ask all this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that lead his affairs to success, forgive my sins and eliminate my shortcomings and errors, and guide me to a straight path, and ask Allah to keep firm on this straight path. Oh Allah, always ask, always make dua, Allah, show us the right path, make us walk on the right path, and make us steadfast on the right path, because your soul, your nafs is there, and Satan is there. So you should always make this dua, and oh Allah, make me firm on this path until I meet the dead, until I die, and change my situation from sin and errors to that of perfection, and forgive me. So we should ask all this, you know, while remembering whom? Hajar radiallahu, Hajar alayhi salam. So وَمَنْ تَتَوَّى خَلْفَدَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى says, and whoever does good voluntarily, it was said that the ayah described performing tawaf more than 7 times. وَمَنْ تَتَوَّى خَيْرًا. Okay. It was also said that it refers to voluntary umrah or hajj. And you know, whenever you go, see, وَمَنْ تَتَوَّى خَيْرًا, and whoever does voluntarily, means that you have done one tawaf. Okay. Do more and more tawaf. But don't, you know, there's a hadith that always create ease, don't create difficulties for others also and for yourself also. If you are tired and you can't do much, then, you know, do as much as you can, you know, because Prophet said that you will get tired by doing after the obligatory prayers, voluntary prayers and voluntary fasting, but Allah will never get tired in giving you the reward. Being a human, we are weak, we get tired, but try to do more than one tawaf there in a day, okay? So, because وَمَنْ تَتَوَّى خَيْرًا, and whoever does good voluntarily, it was said that the ayah describes performing tawaf more than 7 times. It was also said that it refers to voluntarily umrah or hajj, because after one umrah to other umrah, your sins are forgiven. And from one Jummah to other Jummah, if you pray and you are 5 obligatory prayers and you recite Suratul Kaf and, you know, Quran daily. So from one Jummah to other Jummah, sins are forgiven. From one Hajj to other Hajj, sins are forgiven. So Islamically, you can perform Hajj after 5 years, which is why to, you know, avoid the crowd, they follow this Sunnah. Before, they used to give her visa on every year to do pilgrimage. Now to Hajjaj, to pilgrimage, they give a visa according to the Sunnah after 5 years for Hajj to avoid the crowd. It was also said that it means volunteering to do good works in general. As Ar-Razi has stated, the third opinion was attributed to Al-Hasan Al-Basri, that Allah knows the best. And then there is another ayah, in final no there's ayah final no the same ayah the final Allah shakirun aleem then verily Allah is all recognizer all knower Allah is shakirun and aleem he recognize you he appreciate whatever we do little good deeds or more good deeds and he's all knower he knows what we does what we do and then Allah says verily Allah is all recognizer all knower these are the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there are 99 attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when somebody recites the attributes the sifati name nine names of 99 attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and after reciting them make duas so duas are accepted so Allah is all recognizer all knower meaning Allah's reward is immense for the little deed and he knows about the sufficiency of the reward hence he will not award insufficient rewards to anyone he won't award insufficient he would award sufficient reward indeed in allaha la yuzlimu mithqala dharratin wa in taku hasanatan yudaifuha wa yuti min ladunu ajran azima surely allah wrongs not even of the weight of an atom but if there is any good done he doubles it and gives from him a great reward allah doesn't avoid even your deeds are equal to the weight of an atom allah will give you the reward okay so atom is you know very small so now we see the summary ayah number 158 shaair it's not shair see the this word second line shaair now see the first line shaair is the plural of shaira which comes from shaur shaair okay shaair means symbols rituals of the deen that symbolizes the deen they are very obvious that circumambulance khana-e-kaaba is very obvious is very great you know tawaf between from mount safa to mount marwa is very eminent so they are very any symbols you know so rituals of the deen that symbolizes the deen they are very obvious they are very great on safa and marwa there were two idols Isaf and Naila who were worshipped in the times of Jahiliya is the era before Islam came so sahaba the companions of the prophet ﷺ got worried if we do sa'i of safa and marwa isn't it a symbol of Jahiliya practice because they were scared before there were idols so Allah told them that no it is a symbol of Allah because of the sacrifice and faith and tawakkul of Hazrat Hajra Why did Hazrat Hajra do sa'i of Safa and Marwa in search of water? Because it was a barren land. No people were there. Only she and her son Ismail alayhi salam was alone. There was no water to drink, nothing to eat. And whatever Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he left them, whatever they had, it was finished. So he did sa'i of Safa and Marwa in search of water. She was so patient, so humble, so she had so tawakkal and faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah bestowed him, Allah gave him Zamzam as a property. And this Allah, till that this world exists in the time of Qiyamah, it became the ritual of the Hajj. Subhanallah. See, Allah is Shakirun Aleem. He is all recognizer. He recognizes the efforts of whom? Of Hajar alayhi salam. And Allah loved this act so much. His patience and, you know, living into a place which is there is no one, you know, some unknown place, but it was the house of Allah. So it was not unknown, sorry. It was the house of Allah, but no one was there. So Allah is Shakir. Allah is recognizer. He gave the reward. Why did Allah delay giving her water? Allah was testing her to give her the reward and Zamzam water became her property. MashaAllah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why do Muslims do sa'i of Safa and Marwa, the Mount Safa and Marwa? It was because it was the order of Allah that Muslims do sa'i of Safa and Marwa in the remembrance of the strength, willpower, patience and faith of Hazrat Hajra in Allah. So we should have strength. We should be strong mu'min. Allah likes a strong mu'min. We should have willpower And we should have trust and faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should have patience, and we should have a firm belief that Allah is a recognizer, Allah is Shakir, Allah is Alim, Allah is Rahim, His mercy will fall on me, Allah will recognize even the small voluntary good deeds I do, even equal to the weight of atom I do, Allah is Shakir, He will reward me. This would revive the feeling of strength and patience in Muslim. So Hajj is from the root word Hajim Jim. Hajj literally means to intend. You go to perform Hajj with an intention and preparation. We go with the intention, this is the fifth pillar of Islam, and I have to, you know, perform once in my life, and it is for those who can afford. And in affording comes that you should afford the tickets and all your expenses over there. And the other thing, you should leave enough amount for your family behind, that they are not begging from the people that, you know, such and such people have gone for Hajj and money is not left with me and begging. No. You should have enough money behind for your family also. And there also, you shouldn't ask, you know, people, you shouldn't be begging. We shouldn't be begging. And it is the intention that this is the rituals and I have to perform. And we prepare a lot, you know, be aware what we are going to do, what rituals will be there, one after the other, what we have to do. And we should be patient. We should not be fighting. We should not be using bad words, you know, to get more reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we should be prepared that there is a great rush, there is a great, you know, lot of crowd. You know, I will be banged with somebody, someone would hurt me, and I would get little place, and there would be no place for sajda also. Literally, it happens in Ramadan also. I always experience in Ramadan. But this patience will, you know, multiply your rewards. And shouldn't say anything to anybody. Umrah literally means to ziyara, to visit. So it means to visit the house of Allah, because Allah said, away tamara, doing Umrah. So Umrah means to visit the house of Allah with the intention to do Umrah. How is Allah Shakir? He appreciates the good that we do. He is all recognizer. So he is Shakir, meaning recognizer. He appreciates the good that we do. So now what lessons we learn? Don't neglect good deeds. Focus on doing little good deeds. No matter if you don't have big, big things to do. As Allah knows, even small acts of kindness. Allah never wastes the rewards of your patience. Okay, Allah never wastes. Allah will never waste the rewards of our patience. And we see the patience of whom? Of Hazrat Hajra radiallahu anha, that she was bestowed with Zamzam, the water of Zamzam, and till Qiyamah this will last, and we are also benefiting from that. And his patience and his, you know, searching the water and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his strong belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his tawakkul. So Allah made this ritual, this going from one mountain to another in search of water, Allah made it the ritual for Hajj and Umrah, for both. It's the ritual for Umrah, that you have to do 7 tawaf from Safa, starting from Safa till Marwa, Marwa to Safa, Safa to Marwa, 7 times. Allah never wastes the reward of your patience. Tests not necessarily come because Allah is angry with you. When the tests come, don't feel that Allah is angry. Yes, it's sometimes Allah is angry, but necessary, it's not necessarily comes because Allah is angry with you, but because He wants to purify you and give you the reward. And sins are also forgiven. Your status, your rank is elevated also. So my dear daughters and sisters, ask from Allah, have faith, and He will provide you from where you cannot imagine. Okay, I told you that the birds fly in the morning, empty stomach, and they come, their stomach is filled. Allah provides risk, sustenance, provisions from the place where we cannot imagine. Okay, so now the next ayah, we'll do only few ayahs because salah timings are very fast. Winter is short and we started late. I'm so sorry for that. Inshallah, next Saturday, but let's see how much we can do. Now we'll do the word-to-word translation of this ayah. Next ayah, ayah number 159. Inna, indeed, alladhina, those who yaktumuna, they can conceal, hide, ma, what, anzalna, anzala, send down, reveal, Now we anzalna, we send down, we reveal min from al bayyinati, the proof, the clear, explicit wa and al huda, the guidance min from badi, after ma of what bayyinahu, we explain, we explicitly it. Linnasi, for the people, mankind. Li means for, annasi for the people, for the mankind. Fi in al-kitabi, the kitab, the writ, the book, meaning Quran. Ulaika, those. Yal anuhum, he curse them. Yal anu, he curse whom, them is a pronoun. Allahu, Allah, wa and yal anuhum, he curses. Yal anu, he curses whom, them. Allahinun, those who curse. Now try to understand. We'll try to understand, inshallah. Innaladina, verily those who yaktumuna, who conceal ma anzalna, which we have sent down, what we have sent down, minal bayinati, clear proofs. Al bayinati means clear proofs, evidences. Walhuda, and the guidance. You see the screen, please. Mimbadi, after mimbadi ma bayyanahu linnasi, after we have made it clear for the people, where fil kitabi, in the book, ulaika, they are the ones, who are the ones, yal anuhumullahu, cursed by Allah, wa and yal anuhum, cursed by whom? Allahinun, the cursor. So we'll try to understand. Okay, let's understand. Innal ladhina, verily those who yaktumuna, conceal, those who conceal. So here conceals, the root word is kaf ta mim, katama, kitman, katama, kitman. Kitman means to hide, to conceal. You see the third word yaktumuna is from the root word kaf ta mim, to hide, to conceal, kitman. So yaktumuna, they hide. What they hide? Ma anzalna min al bayyinati, bayyina. See the word bayyina, bayyina, clear evidence. Okay, bayyina. What is the meaning of bayyinat here? Clear signs, min al bayyinati, clear proofs, evidence, clear signs that proves Allah's existence, Allah's knowledge, Allah's power. It includes evidences that prove the truthfulness of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It includes both. Okay. Okay, then Allah says, Wal Huda. See the word after Bayana, see the screen, Wal Huda. Huda means guidance. So there are two types of ilm and amal. So guidance is of two types, ilm and amal. Ilm means knowledge, and when you seek knowledge, you have to change your amal, your deeds also. So here it means guidance of knowledge. Wal Huda means the guidance of knowledge, the revealed knowledge. What type of knowledge they had? Verily those who conceal, what they conceal, what type of knowledge they conceal, ma anzalna min al bayyinati wal huda, they conceal clear proofs, evidences and the guidance. All types of what they hide, all types of knowledge, particularly of the deen, they hide the knowledge of deen. What does it mean that Allah has cursed them? See, ulaika, they are those yal anhumullah, the ones cursed by Allah. What does that mean? That Allah has cursed them. It means Allah has removed them far away from the mercy. They are away from the rahim, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because they hide, they conceal min al bayyinati wal huda, which Allah has revealed, the clear proofs, the evidences, and the guidance. Which means the science that proves Allah's existence, the knowledge, the revealed knowledge, the power, and that includes the evidences that prove the truthfulness of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So Allah has removed them from far away from His mercy. Yal anuhumullah. They are the ones cursed by Allah. Who else curses such people? Wayal anuhumullainun. Wayal anuhumullainun. Who else curses them? Wayal anuhum, and cursed by whom? Allah inun, by the cursors. So who else curses such people? Who are the cursors? Those who are cursing them? those who hide the concealed Allah's revelation. Law, the cursors are the loyal creations of Allah, example angels and righteous people. Wayal anahumul la'inun, Allah will curse them and cursed by the cursors. The cursors are the loyal creation of Allah, the angels and the righteous people also curse them. So how are ayat bayanat mentioned in the Quran? They are mentioned in the Quran, bayanat are in two ways. Okay, bayanat means clear proofs, evidences. So bayanat are mentioned in Quran mujmal in a very comprehensive way, mufassil in a very detailed way also. You will find the bayanat, the clear proofs, evidences in mujmal form also, in mufassil form also, in a comprehensive way also, and in very detailed way also. And every week we read that, we learn that. In how many ways the knowledge is concealed? Now understand, try to, if someone asks you that you know about something and you tell them no I don't know, and you don't tell them, right? So number one, the knowledge is concealed, is hidden. It's if someone asks you that do you know about and you do and you tell them no I don't know that, don't know. Number two, when you see someone doing wrong or harming himself, you do not tell him. Someone is doing suicide and you are not stopping, that is haram. Okay. And in other ways, you know, drinking or doing something, gambling, and you are not, you know, stopping him. So when you see someone doing wrong or harming himself, you do not tell them. It means you are concealing. So it's kitman, it's yaktumuna. So these people are cursed by Allah. Yal anuhumullahu wa yal anuhumul la'inun. Okay. So they are cursed by the people, by Allah, by the righteous people, by the angels also. Okay. So now we see the tafsir and then we'll end so we learn the lesson from here. Concealing knowledge is very huge crime. Concealing the knowledge of the deen is major sin. It is as bad as other major sins. Act upon your knowledge and convey it to others. You come here to classes, whatever you learn, act upon your knowledge. Your deeds should be, your amal should be according to the Quran and Sunnah, according to the Quran and Sunnah, and pass the word. Bring people also to the halaqa, your friends, your relatives, your cousins, your aunties. Not doing this means a person is wasting himself. Your deeds are not according to the Quran and Sunnah, you are wasting yourself. You are not calling to these sorts of halaqa, Quran teaching, then you are wasting yourself. Everything that is needed for us to know has been given to us in this Quran. So call people towards Quran. This way their tazkiyah will be done, they will be purified, and they will be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will be happy from them, and they will get Jannatul Firdaus al-Ala. Verily, those who conceal the clear proofs, evidences, the bayinat and the huda and the guidance which we have sent down after we have made it clear for the people in the book, they are the ones cursed by Allah and cursed by the cursors. These ayahs sternly warn against those who hide the clear signs that the messenger was sent with which guide to the correct path and beneficial guidance for the heart. Allah, after Allah has made such aspects clear for his servants through the books that he revealed to his messenger. So whatever Allah has revealed, Allah wants us. So Allah has made such aspects clear for his servants also through the books. Abu al-Aliya said that these ayat were revealed about the people of scripture who hid the description of Muhammad Sassam. Everything was there, the signs of Prophet Sassam, the signs of Medina was also there in their book, and they hid. They used to do kitman, they used to hide, they used to conceal. Then Allah states that everything curses such people for this evil act. Certainly, just as everything asks for the forgiveness for the scholar, even the fish in the sea and the bird in the air, then these who hide the knowledge are cursed by Allah and the cursor. See, when you are on the path of seeking knowledge, everything asks forgiveness for you, because you have come to this halqa. No matter, you have come on Zoom, Allah knows. We are, you know, passing from the test, from the pandemic, from the epidemic. We are not, you know, this is a social distance. So we are doing on internet, on Zoom, but we are getting the reward. So everything asks forgiveness for the seeker of knowledge, for the scholar. You are the seeker of knowledge. Even the fish in the sea, make dua for you. The bird in the air make dua for you. In the same way, those who hide the knowledge are cursed by the Allah and by the cursors. by the fish in the sea, by the bird in the air, by the angels, by the noble people. Allah then states that everything curses such people for this evil act. Certainly, just as everything asks for forgiveness for the scholar, even the fish in the sea and the bird in the air and those who hide knowledge are cursed by Allah and by the curser. So you are the chosen one. You know, everything is asking forgiveness for you and me, even the fish in the sea, the bird in the air. A hadith in the Musnad narrated through several chains of narrators that strengthens the overall judgment of the hadith states that Abu Huraira narrated that Allah's messenger said, whoever was asked about knowledge, that one has, but he bid it, but he hid it. Whoever was asked about the knowledge that one has, but he hid it, then a bridle made of a fire will be tied around his mouth on the day of resurrection. If I don't do this halaqa, and if I hide this knowledge, and whoever knows this, then what will happen? Then if they hide, then a bridle made of fire will be tied around the mouth of on the day of resurrection. May Allah save us from this torment. May Allah doesn't make us from them. This is also recorded by Al-Bukhari. That's a very interesting hadith. Abu Huraira said, if it was not for an ayah in Allah's book, I would not have narrated a hadith for everyone. Inna allazeena yaktumuna ma anzalna min al-bayyinati wal-huda. If this ayat was not in the Quran, I would have not narrated the hadith. And Abu Huraira has narrated many hadith. We find 2,500 hadith narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu himself. And you know, people used to say at that time, Abu Huraira always narrates the hadith. So Abu Huraira said, when you people go to markets and other places, I was attached with Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. People has to go to the market. People has to go for, you know, for their livelihood to earn bread and butter. But Abu Huraira always sat in the mosque with Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he used to learn the knowledge. He was not working anywhere. This is why he has, you know, given us 2,500 hadiths he has narrated. And he's, you know, he used to feed her himself on the dates which used to come and into the mosque of Masjid Nabawi. Verily, those who conceal the clear proofs, evidences, and the guidance which we have sent on. If this ayat was not there, I would have never narrated the hadith. He was so much scared because it is said in this ayat that those who conceal, those who kitman haq, what will happen? Allah will curse them. Allah, the lanat of Allah will fall on them, and the cursor will also curse them, meaning the noble people, the and the angels, and all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mujahid said, when the earth is struck by drought, the animals say, what is drought? Famine, when there is no crops grown. This is because of the sinners among the children of Adam. May Allah curse the sinners among the children of Adam. And there's another hadith said that commentary said that wayal anuhumul la'inun, and cursed by the cursors means that the angels and the believers will curse them. Moreover, a hadith states that everything, including the fish in the sea, asks for the forgiveness for the scholars, and the ayah states that those who hide the knowledge will be cursed in this life and on the day of resurrection by Allah, the angels, all humanity, and those who curse, including the animals, each in its own distant way. And Allah knows the best. Now we'll conclude here. Let's see the summary. I won't take the reflection today because Maghrib will be very soon. Ayah 159, Kitman, to hide something. Kitman is from Kaf, Ta, Mim, root word, and Kitman, to hide something. So Yaktumuna, they hide. What they hide? Bayyana, clear evidences. What is the meaning of Bayyanat here? Clear signs that proves Allah's existence, knowledge, power, and it also includes evidences that prove the truthfulness of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Everything was written in their books, Torah, Zubur, Injil, that these are the signs of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He will be like this, and Medina will be the place, and there was the signs of Medina also, which is why they settled down in Medina. They knew that the palm trees would be there. So they found the palm trees in Medina and they settled there. So Huda, guidance. The Huda, Hidayat, is of two types, Ilm and Amal. So when you acquire this Ilm, when you acquire this knowledge, Quran and Hadith, so your Amal should also be, your deeds should be according to that. Here it means guidance of knowledge. What types of knowledge they hide? All types of knowledge, particularly of the deen. What does it mean? Allah has cursed them. Allah has removed them far away from His mercy. Curse means what? Lanat means moss. Allah has removed them far away from His mercy. Who else curses such people? Loyal creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Example, angels, righteous people. How are ayat, bayanat mentioned in the Quran? They are mentioned in two ways. Mujmal, in a very comprehensive way. Mufassal, in a very detailed way. And day by day we learn these, mashallah. In how many ways the knowledge is concealed? If someone asks you that you know about and you do not tell them. Number two, when you see someone doing wrong or harming himself, you do not tell him. So what lessons we learn? Concealing knowledge is a very huge crime. Concealing the knowledge of the deen is a major sin. It is as bad as other major sins. Act upon your knowledge, your amal, your deed should be according to your knowledge and convey it to others. So whatever you learn, share it with your parents, with your siblings, with your friends, with your relatives, with your neighbors, but not, you know, be a burden on them. Just there is a, you know, with wisdom. So see, is it the appropriate time to say something? You should know the appropriate time to say on, you know, appropriate things. Do not doing this means a person is wasting himself. Bring more and more people, to give this Zoom link to more and more sisters and aunties. Everything that is needed for us to know has been given to us in this Quran. We don't need anybody else. Everything is in the Quran. Whatever we praying, salah, zakah, performing hajj, all the rituals are here. Okay. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك جزاك الله خيرا كثيرا كثيرا بارك الله في علمك وعملك ورزقكم وأوقاتكم وأهلكم ومالكم آمين يا رب العالمين May Allah give you barakah in your knowledge, in your deeds, in your risk provision and sustenance, in your family, in your time. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. May Allah accept from all of us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Okay, if you all give one reflection, come on. One point each, come on, start. Fast, who will start first? Come on.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.